right, that the water provides us with this place of comfort and creation. It also is a source of chaos. As Elaine was reminding us earlier, there's all the flooding from Harvey and Irma and Maria. It is both and. Our text today invites us into the blessing that is ours, that all of creation is for us, that God blesses us and cares for us, each and every one of us. It is the river of the water of life that flows through the city. And on its banks are the trees of life that have the fruit of 12 different fruits. And its leaves are for the healing of the nations. This isn't just for this one particular city, whatever city was imagined. It is for the world. It is for all of us. The message, the blessing, is for all of us. Whether we are sitting by the river and enjoying how it flows, or we are caught up in the flooding that occurs in numerous places, it is a blessing for us. After worship 2 weeks ago on Rally Sunday, the first day I wore this stole, a number of you asked me about it. It is a stole that was created, I mean, there are a number of these stoles. I don't know if they're exactly alike, but they're probably very similar. Every year since 1995, one person has created stoles for the United Church of Christ when it gathers in synod. It's Reverend Brenda Brower designed this. And this is to reflect the theme of the synod, and I'm gonna take it off because it's, I'm gonna put it back on. But it is from the theme of the synod, which comes from Psalm 46:4. There is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, a source of life for all of us. And, you know, when you greet me at the back of the sanctuary at the close of the service, I invite you to take a closer look at it. It's many images of creation that are very compelling, and obviously I can't do this one-handed or without a mirror. Yes. So the day, of course, when I might have chosen not to wear my robe, I wanted to wear this. Oh, well, it's what it is, isn't it? As I was preparing for worship this morning, I was remembering a number of experiences that I've had on fresh water and the reality of flooding around the world. We canoed on the Wisconsin River, which is a pretty powerful river, and were struck by the towering rock faces and the lush forest that surrounded us. And this year, South America, Africa, Europe, and Asia have experienced record flooding, leaving many dead, and cities and villages in rubble. We hiked and camped in the wilderness in the Rocky Mountains, drinking water directly from a stream that was fed by the glacier. And it was fresh, and it was clean. And you were reminded of the story of Flint, Michigan, and the lead-tainted water of the Flint River. We would pontoon on Lake Shelbyville, pulling an inner tube behind, a lake created by damming the Kaskaskia River. You all know there was record flooding along the Des Plaines and the Fox Rivers. We floated down a rivulet in Michigan. It was this tiny little thing, and suddenly it opens up into this wide river that we hadn't expected. And we floated along that too. And we're aware of the devastation in the wake of hurricanes. Harvey, Irma, Maria. This is the truth of life. There is always chaos, and there is always hope. I might not be living in the chaos at the moment, but someone I know and love surely is. And I am called to be present to their chaos, not to suggest that I can fix it, because I can't. But what I can do is be present. Sometimes I am filled with hope, and other times it seems to be lacking. But someone I know and love, maybe it's someone here, maybe it's someone in my family, maybe it's one of my friends, someone will have enough hope to share with me and sit with me until that hope returns. Chaos and hope, it's a part of life. I think sometimes we tell ourselves, there must be something wrong with me, my life is always so chaotic, or how could this have happened if I weren't doing the right things? It is part of life. Yesterday when we met for worship planning, I think it was Maureen had the image of storing up. Storing up what we need to make it through the difficult times. And hopefully coming to worship helps store up some of that hope for you. So that tomorrow, when the roof falls in, you go, ah yes, it's just part of the chaos. I'll be all right. Storing up, it's okay. Because it's the kind of story that you share, right? It's not like you have a pantry full of beans that no one else gets to eat. It's a pantry full of hope and love that you can draw on when you need to, and you can pull out of when you've got a friend who needs more than you have or than they have. Chaos and hope. It's a part of life. And this text is a blessing to all of us. I saw the river of the water of life and the trees of life with 12 different kinds of fruit and the leaves that were used for the healing of the nations. We are all blessed. May we find that blessing inside of us so that we can be a blessing to others in return.